Okay, I realize this feedback isn't real-world representative values, but it's a feedback among Linux fans, which makes it much more interesting. I'm going to keep this video short, and thank you for your participation. So, let's roll! The first question was, what Linux are you using? That includes all the spins and the based ons. For example, Ubuntu was choice for elementary 2, and Arch Linux was also the choice for Manjaro users. So, 33% are using Ubuntu, 33% are using Arch Linux, and 14% are using Fedora. Those three combined, and whatever is based on them, are the 80% of the total Linux user base. On the second question, people are voting on what Linux they would be using, if they wouldn't using their current from the above results. In that case, Fedora comes first with 24%, Ubuntu comes second with 22%, Arch Linux drops to 21%, and Debian becomes significant, but not too much, with 14%. Those results alone aren't very helpful to understand what's going on, so I produced some additional graphs. On YouTube description I'm giving links both for Google Forms and spreadsheets, if you want to vote or just check on the results yourselves. Oh, and around 2% voted the same main and alternative Linux and desktop, but I obviously removed those votes. So, on this graph I only count the answers of Ubuntu users, and the 30% of them would be using Fedora as an alternative, 29% would be using Arch Linux, and only 21% would be using Debian, that Ubuntu is supposed to be based on. Same as Ubuntu, but with Arch Linux this time. So, 33% of current Arch Linux users would be jumping to Ubuntu, 29% would have gone for Fedora, and 14% would have chosen Debian. Similar to Linux distros but with Linux desktops this time. So, 57% are on GNOME shell, with Plasma following way behind with 20%. Combine these two desktops have almost 80% of the total user base, and so much for the actual point of the rest 1000 desktops, and the Linux desktop choice. And these results aren't specific to this YouTube channel, those numbers are actually very close to real world. Most probably in real world GNOME and Plasma percentages are even higher. Okay, and now what would be people's alternative desktops, and of course there are some super mess here. So, Plasma is gaining GNOME users and comes first with 27%, GNOME follows second with 20%, and third place goes to XFCE and Mate Alliance. I put those desktops together, because they are very similar between them. In fact I never got why Mate was created, they could just invest on XFCE. Not that it matters, because people don't use either of them, but anyway. Now filtering only GNOME users' responses, we get a 38% going to Plasma rather selecting some other GTK-based desktop. For example, elementary is theoretically a very similar to GNOME desktop, and yet, in practice only 14% would have preferred it as a GNOME alternative. XFCE and Mate are actually 4 units above elementary to 18%, and window tiling managers climb to 12%. You see? GNOME users are the real geeks. Remember that only 38% of GNOME users picked Plasma as second choice, because if we go to Plasma side, we'll see that 45% of Plasma users would have picked GNOME desktop as an alternative. That's 7 units up. Second most popular choice for Plasma users is the same with GNOME, with XFCE and Mate in 19%. And look at this! Window tiling managers are on 6%, half the percentage of GNOME. Told you! GNOME users are the real geeks! Next to some various stuff, like how many years people are using Linux. That's the first year of Linux desktop for 14% of people, and 32% are also pretty new to Linux. And anyway, those are very related to this channel, and I added them so I can connect the rest graphs in comparison to users' experience, but I'm not going to make a huge video discussing such metrics. Next we see that only 44% use Linux exclusively in their home, which makes perfect sense really. 65% of people have switched Linux distro inside the last 2 years, and almost the same with 68% have switched desktop too. However, more than 80% of switchers are people that use Linux from 1 to 4 years, while more experienced users are super loyal. And finally, this is how people are rating the progress of Linux Desktop. It averages a 7.5, and it is the same both for new and old users. Personally, I thought that new users would have rated higher, because old users should have more expectations, but I was wrong. But I definitely consider 7.5 super high rating. With 7.5, Linux should have had at least 12% market share, and not be stacked on 2 or 3% for a century.